been a great run. The guys are all on top of their games. They're all playing for each other. This team really believes in each other, and you can see it with their play on the ice.
Yanni Gord is on with Braden Point. Here's Miller to the net. He scores! Rangers win! What a goal by JT Miller at 1:19 of overtime. JT Miller with a brilliant goal wins it for the Rangers.
We talked about Scheifele and Seguin, Dave, facing off to start this game. They've already had a game.
Yeah, they certainly have superstitions. I'm last off. No, you're last off. Okay, what do? Rock, paper, scissors. Don't know if I like Seguin's game here. He goes to rock a couple of times. Scheifele gets him in the end. Mind game start literally between those two.
Cross ice, shot score! And the Jets have a 1-0 lead. Morrissey, the shot from the line. Score! Scheifele goes to the front of the net.
His second of the night with mom and dad in the crowd.
Wheeler has it again up for Scheifele at the empty net. There's a hat trick. And this will put the game away for the Winnipeg Jets. And with mom and dad in the crowd, Mark Scheifele gets a hat trick.
Kurinski in the corner for Bjorkstrand, gets right back up. Good work by the youngster, fires and scores. What a goal! His second of the night, and it was a great individual effort to give the Jackets a 2-goal lead.
Oh, top shelf
over Niemi. He knows he's got no chance.
Nail has a cane on him, finds Greer, far side Nemeth, and a bomb, score! That's his first career National Hockey League goal. Let's listen in. For Patrick Nemeth, career game number 118, and it's career goal number one.
O'Reilly, back to the front, oh, what a stop on Tiranta! Robbing Julia, save of the night.
That will test the lower body injury. Are you kidding me? What a save. Go, go, gadget legs.
6 minutes to go here in the second. And look out. Peter Budaj making a glove save. That was a beauty as the puck was deflected into the bench area.
That was.
Oh, my gosh.
He was ready. He's got a little smile on his face, too. Collecting it. Protecting the police department, too. Little reversal there. Watch this deflection. By Kalorin, gets the glove up. Those goalies are ready everywhere. Great save.
The offensive end rolls up, shot blocked. Corrali, redirection on net. Linus able to keep it out of there, and then they have a little help in front of him.
On to the right to Pastrnak. Long shot and rebound. Bergeron, oh, what a save by Legacy.
That could be a penalty shot.
It could be, and it will be.
And here he comes on quick. Austin Matthews works in, scores! A slick move by Austin Matthews. He's got his 10th of the year. It's on a penalty shot, and Toronto's down 5-1.
Loose puck, Colin scores! First of the season for Matt Cullen on his 41st birthday, and the Wild have the game's first goal.
That is just not very Carey Price-like, at least not the one that we've seen over the last 5 or 6 years.
And they score again! And a wrist shot from the point by Dumba. It looked like it was tipped out front, and it's 2-zip Wild.
So Cullen gets Minnesota's first goal. The second one comes 10 seconds later on a wrist shot by Dumba.
He works it down to Brown, a little back pass. Oh, what a stop by McElhinney on Kopitar. What a stop.
Absolutely brilliant save by McElhinney.
What a night for Semi Varlamov.
57 saves for Varlamov. That's 95% save percentage tonight.
You faced a career high and an avalanche high 60 shots on goal, made 57 saves. How would you characterize your performance out here?
I don't know either. You know, it was a tough game. It was a tough start for me. I had to bounce back today after the last game in Vegas when we gave up the 7 goals. So,
1972,
Blues and Flyers at the old Spectrum. Look at what's going on here. Blues players climbing into the stands.
The referee again on the faceoff was kicking one of our players out. Then just to punish us, he dropped the puck and they scored the goal. And from then, when they went off the ice, Al Arbor jumped on the ice, followed him off the ice. Al was arguing in the runway with the referee, and the fans come running down and threw something at Al and took a swing at him. So right away, Al being the coach, I had to do something. So I dropped my stick and gloves, and I went up in the stands after him. And now, being the city of brotherly love, the three of us thought we'd go up there and show a little love.